Hey everybody, it's Fortiware. Welcome back to XCom Enemy Unknown. So, last time we got introduced to a new alien, I blew myself up with a rocket, and the game lied to me on that one too, and I missed another 96 in the same battle. But overall, we made a lot of progress thanks to monetary requests. Really, I'm making out well. The heavy lasers one was huge, gave me 311, and then I got 290 more from the lasers. Honestly, I couldn't ask for anything better right now about that. So I'm making out like a bandit in that regard. But I can't keep relying on it. Anyway, after analyzing my situation here, I realized the smart thing for me to do if I wanted to have 20 engineers would be to go to Brazil. Get that done. Unfortunately, that would also have a real consequence here. If I ignore Australia, I will lose them. Unless a terror mission saves my ass. The same goes with the UK, actually, and Germany. Germany's also got four. Panic. And I have one satellite I can use to save one country. Right now, South Africa's panicked. So, strategically, if you really want to please everybody, you kind of need to do one of these. The question is, which? Well, I think the obvious one is definitely Birmingham. The UK. I think that this is the obvious call. I get 200 more credits, which is nice. So it's a pretty sexy deal. I love it when the rewards coincide with the panic. It feels convenient. We did get all laser weapons now last time, but unfortunately I can't only build so many because I've been happily going through my alien alloys like they're going out of style. But you know, you gotta do what you gotta do. And I regret nothing. Let's see here. Who can I... I probably want to build up some more people. At least that's the idea here. So I think I'm going to go and try to get Mr. Peters ready and rolling. Go. I'd imagine there's going to be floaters, mutons, again, kind of just the same thing. The mutons might have heavy plasma rifles this time along, and I really should have brought an arc thrower just in case. We should get down there and eliminate any hostiles. And this looks like. Normally this one is a terror mission site. Strike 1 is awaiting drop clearance. Copy that, big sir. But whatever. Strike 1 is cleared to engage hostile targets. I've seen this one hundreds of times. There will almost always be aliens around here, almost around here, usually around this truck that's over here you can't see, and usually some around this back truck in the corner here. So we'll see what happens. Down. Chalk up another. As smooth as it could possibly get. It was a really strange one with 8 thin men and 2 floaters. Not to mention, the thin men kept seemingly all too happy to run right to me. Which, when you have 2 snipers and Overwatch with 1 opportunist, is basically playing into my hands. It was really strange. Yeah, that was insane. I didn't get attacked once. Except for the one time where a reaction shot was taken, but guess who was the one drawing the fire? My assault unit, which meant lightning reflexes, meant a guaranteed miss. Let's see, dense smoke, making my smoke grenades more effective, or combat drugs, giving them extra will and crit chance. I think now you gotta go dense smoke, you're going pure defensive. And he gets opportunists now, which is huge. So, yeah. Honestly, could that have gone better? Probably not. I honestly was overjoyed. So, 9 days left. I guarantee you a terror mission's coming right down the pike very, very soon. Man, with so much stuff. So much stuff, so much money, unusually for me. Actually, this gave me this, which is nice. If 14 days, I don't care. You could have multiple things going on simultaneously, so you don't have to worry about that.
To the Foundry crews now. You can follow their progress remotely from the project team in engineering.
And let's see here. Normally I don't have this much money to play with, so it's kind of an embarrassment of riches right now for me. And you know how quickly I get rid of it, right? I think what I'm going to do... I almost want to build one more power generator just to have it. Add 5 engineers to my staff, or increase in research speed. Oof, that's tough. I could really do this though, which would be nice.
These are at full capacity. We should build additional uplinks as soon as possible.
When all this fails, consider getting yourself more satellites. Honestly, why would I not?
Commander, the council's...
Okay.
Secure transmission coming in now.
Panic reduction. A target extraction, and 2 engineers, and some nice more funds! It's like, wow! So, let's see, Egypt. Egypt is looking average. I don't know if it'll affect Africa at all, but whatever. I'm trying to see which one this is, though. Okay, I think it's that one. Well, I just dealt with a bunch of Thinmen before, so let's deal with this, I guess. Same crew, because nothing changes. Nothing. Now, the first council mission we did was a bomb disposal. This is going to be a little different.
Just inside the Egyptian border.
Because we're going to have to find a target and secure it. And once you secure the target, you're going to then have to deal with reinforcements. So there's already a few enemies on the way, and then there'll be reinforcements as soon as you do that. The whole key, though, is to get the target back to the Sky Ranger, but also to take care of the enemies as they show up. I think you have to take care of every enemy, I'm not sure though.
Thomas Hutch, a friend of the council, was riding in the limo at the bottom of those steps when it was hit by an alien ambush. We need you to find Mr. Hutch, make sure he's safe, and get him safely back to the Sky Ranger. Objective updated.
There are multiple target extractions they can give you. In my opinion, this one is probably... They can range anywhere, I should say. No, extractions, I'm sorry. There's 2 that are like extractions in the sense you have to find the target, and then there's a couple that are like escort missions. So, a little difference there. Kind of splint hairs, but...
Aye, aye, Commander.
That's what we got. Anyway. Idea is to take it slow. The target will always be in the same area. In this case, Hutch will be on this road right here, which basically is screaming killing floor based on the raised positions around. And the aliens like to show up in the back or on the road. So you do have to be careful. I also had a glitch happen here one time where one of my troops was suspended in midair. It was comical. Oh, incredibly, I spotted somebody already. Okay, then. It looks like it's just one of them. Well... All the more reason to get myself an opportunist. Because who doesn't like an opportunist? Who doesn't like an ultimate opportunist? I sure do. Especially when I'm the one profiting.
Hey, we could really use a hand with these things.
Sure enough. XCom has stopped working. Oh, joy. So unfortunately, due to the randomization of everything, I had to redo the alien abduction mission, and the challenging part of that was doing it perfectly, because that's what I ended up doing last time, which I ended up doing. But as you see, we now have a target escort instead of an extraction. A politician from Brazil, who once advocated cooperation. So we have panic reduction in a different country, unfortunately, and our rewards are different. Instead of getting, you know, 2 engineers and 151 credits, we now get a heavy captain. Now, not bad. I mean, it's not a bad trade. I just hate it because the way it came about was the game just fucking decided to crash on me. Target escort. Kind of similar in premise to the extraction. You'll have a few enemies roaming about. Thim in, obviously. But this time, once you get your target to the evac point, that's when everybody starts raining on you. And I think there'll be reinforcements during the extraction as well. So, yeah, you get to look forward to that. I actually did use an alien grenade as I was trying to do the abductions perfectly. Luckily, everything else kind of stayed the same. The promotions were the same and everything. And as you see, I got my alien grenade back. So, yay. Let's go. And please don't crash on me. So this escort mission right here, this one, it's kind of screams scary because of where they're going to place you.
So that's where we're going next.
And once again, it's a corrupt politician. Everyone's favorite, because who has never seen a corrupt politician in their lifetimes? In this case, it's William Thorne, the snitch. I mean, the person in question.
Get him to the Sky Ranger for evac.
Collusion with the aliens. Oh, jeez. Well, that's a new twist on it, I guess. It's not insider trading or anything this time. So you see we have this little alley here. Unfortunately, you're going to have them in up and about. They're going to be in the center, they're going to be up here, they're going to be over in the other top of the other building, or they'll be in the buildings, or they may be in the corners right as you get to the end of the road. So, not making a mistake this time, we're saving this MF-er. This is why I keep saves, people. I don't do this for revisionist history nonsense. I do it to prevent the revisionist history. Count that, okay? These saves right here sound like save scumming techniques, but look what they're doing in reality here. I have now played revisionist history on this game's revisionist history. I'm preventing revisionist history. I'm frying my brain and trying to wrap my head around this right now. So, unsurprisingly, there's two right here. There always is. Fortunately, because they can jump over the building, that's what they do. They is hacksaws. Eh, why not? Personally, I like trying to get my snipers on the rooftops, because it's easier to look down on the foe as opposed to looking up. However, sometimes things just don't work out that way for you. So, yeah. Is what it is.
On it.
Also, you don't expose aliens inside the building when you go on top of the building. Makes perfect sense, wouldn't you agree? It also helps to keep an ongoing presence as you advance. So unfortunately, that kind of got thrown out in the first turn. So you can take as many turns as you want with this VIP, so I'd recommend taking the max. Take as many as you need. You don't have to worry. I'm a little worried about that Thimmin that's roaming about right now, because who knows what's going to happen next turn.
This is absurd! Do you honestly think I would turn my back on my country? I am not a traitor, dammit!
That's funny, because that's exactly what a politician who is corrupt would say when he is embroiled in a scandal. I know, I'm playing, you know, that's what they all would say, As you see, they're restarting with the reinforcements. This time, out there, and they like being in Overwatch. Unfortunate, to say the least. And unfortunately, they're in an area I can't really readily access. Now you're just playing dirty. That's right, we put one right on top of the frickin'. Yeah. They did. They put them there. That's a dirty place to put them. But, they put them there. There's no drain pipe here either. It's like, how do you access this? Oh, this one's gonna be. This is gonna hurt. This is going to hurt a lot.
You have right to do this. I work for the people. On whose authority do you operate?
Like we need authority. We're XCom. We're saving the world. Terrorist, your game is through, because I answer to XCom. Fuck yeah. Select that button and suck on my balls. Yeah, sure. Okay, truthfully, I'm not very pleased about this predicament. I'm already in a predicament right now.
Heading there now. Hostile spotted.
Yeah, you know, we spotted him. Great. He ain't gonna move because he's... Daniels! Get off your knees and quit blowing the mission. Honestly. This is not okay. This guy might actually have to save your ass again because he's awesome. Unfortunately, there's a myriad of enemies here that I just can't seem to find. And it actually is really upsetting. The other option here is that you burn a rocket, put it in a blind area because you know the enemy is there, and see what happens. Of course, what's the obvious drawback? This guy'd be fucked. And there very well could be a case where he tries to spot me and blast my politician out of the water. And let's be honest here. The guy's a scumbag, but can't have that happen right now. You can't.
I feel, Commander.
This could be a disaster. I'm actually giving myself a free mulligan for this because the game, when the game fucks with you, you fuck with the game right back. That's kind of the whole way it works. And the game fucked with me by not giving me the hutch mission. Not like saying I would have done better with it, because I don't know, truthfully, but just the whole thing is garbage. The whole thing is garbage here. Wow. Nice. So we got two of them out there, but there's still two aliens, I think, left? Yeah, I think there's two aliens left right now. The jackass that's up top is one of them. This guy right here. Gotta love my sniper. I love my snipers. I love my snipers. They are my closest friends.
Heading to that location.
Because they are bad, bad men. Unfortunately, I know there's still an enemy just roaming. And roaming and roaming and roaming. So, what does it all mean? I honestly don't know. There's still an alien up top. I'm calling it right now.
I will not speak to anyone until I'm given proper legal representation.
Kiss my ass. You don't deserve it. You have the right to remain silent. I pray to God you start fucking using it. You'll do us all a favor. I love how politicians just scream like little children when they get caught. Ugh. It's so beautiful. I really do get a sixth sense of satisfaction for this one to an extent. Hey, here's the fifth guy. Daniels! Score! You did something, Daniels! Congratulations! You didn't need the sniper to bail your ass out this time. And now, with that, I can now relax. And believe me, I'm going to relax. At least for the time being. I'm safe for now. Kind of like Friday the 13th game. You live for now. Because truthfully, I want to take it slow. I'm about to expose more aliens, so I just want to make sure I'm not doing anything, you know, excessively stupid here. Don't move forward too crazily here. And also, remember you have these guys. These guys are worth the weight in gold in situations like this. They're worth the weight in gold in pretty much any situation. But especially when you have a sniper's nest. Oof. Oofa. So, as you see, we did spot somebody, and thankfully he's exercising his right to shut the fuck up. And unfortunately, it's kind of like, as I said, Hariri can't really do anything here.
Roger that.
But that's okay.
I'm on it.
I trust Bakani as well, so not too worried. Oh yeah, it's the first time you have a civilian, so they have one function. Head down. It's kind of like hunker down. Because that actually gives them some coverage, which is nice. This guy's already in fucking cover. What the hell is this shit? He's down. Nice. Kind of tells you how incredible the ballast scanner is. It was on the ground and spotted somebody above.
Heading there now.
Aliens like to show up also in that corner, far corner over there. I'm banking on it. But I think we're in pretty decent shape right now.
On my way.
At least for now, because as we advance. The funny thing about extractions and escorts, the farther you advance,
reloaded,
the more likely it is you're going to be jumped on. It's like the game predetermines its reinforcements based on where you go, or based specifically where your target is. So if you really want to game the system, you would, you know, move your target like a little bit, like a tile or two at a time, and then you would stop. If you discover reinforcements, you get rid of them, and then you wait, and then you move again. It's a little dirty, but it works. Sometimes you need it. Sometimes you need that, because now we're about halfway through. We're now going to have more reinforcements, and sure enough, they're on the roofs again. Like I said, they like the roof. They really do. Unfortunately, they're not going to like this. Beautiful. It was just one of them, too. So it wasn't three, which is nice. If you see, like, three or four reinforcements, that means you must have moved your civilian friend really far. You don't want to do that ever. For this express reason. Remember, you have all the time in the world to do this. You have all the time in the world. That's the whole point of these escorts and extractions. So you don't want to just jump to conclusions. Go crazy.
Copy that.
And you'd never, ever, ever have your civilian run out when an Overwatch is in play. Never. Because these are thin men. They cheat. They'll hit you every time. Or feels like it at least every time. Even with that so-called dash function, which is supposed to make you a little harder to hit. Yeah, it don't happen that way. It don't happen that way.
Affirmative. On Overwatch.
And if you're about to get very close to the Skyranger, definitely don't come up like two tiles short, because that usually means there's an alien nearby and he's gonna wreck you. I speak from experience. Or whether it was from me doing it, or whether it was from somebody else doing it. I speak from experience. So I speak from first and second hand experience. I think I covered most of the hands, but not third hand experience. I don't know what third hand experience would be in this case. No aliens jumping down, so that means I need to move my guy a little bit. I'm also gonna do this. Get a chance to get people on the roof, you take it. Even if it's for nothing other than vantage points, you take it. There is a 150% chance there's aliens over here.
Good to go.
Calling it right now. I mean, I'm not a great prognosticator by any stretch of the imagination, but even I know that's what's coming. There should be one that pops up over there. That's my hunch.
On it. Roger that. Scanning.
Every guy's a politician. He's not exactly in shape. It's kind of funny how you get to control him and no one else does. And yes, they have default ranks. What do they mean? Absolutely nothing. But it's kind of comical to see that. Okay.
Will do. Got it covered.
Nobody there. As soon as I turn this corner, I guarantee you. Hi, Thin Man. Enemy troops. Hi, Thin Man! It's like I said. Did I call it or what? And he's going... Oh, great. He's conveniently going over there. Luckily, I have the right thing to say to that.
Affirmative.
It's called, how do you like my grenades? Oh, boy. Well, he did pick a good position to hide. Fortunately, I have a very good answer for him.
Catch.
Hopefully, I don't discover anybody else by accident. Because if you hit an alien there with a grenade that in a group you haven't noticed, that triggers them. So that alien grenade would backfire quickly.
Copy that.
Wouldn't be pretty. But luckily, I think I got rid of pretty much every alien that is here. Now all that's left is just reinforcements. Unfortunately, Jackass here still can't make it. The only aliens left will be ones that are inside the stores. The buildings. If, you know, they're actually there, which they may not be.
Come get some. On Overwatch. Eyes peeled, Commander.
We're receiving reports of heavy X-ray activity in that area.
And yep, because I'm getting close. Well, I wonder how this is going to turn out. I love that part. Hey, what is ambushing you? I got the drop on. Oh crap! Then they see five of them. They go, oh crap. So anyway, this politician here can get in the Sky Ranger and.
I demand answers.
VIP is safe and on board.
Unfortunately, it means there's still aliens roaming.
Work, Strike One. Wipe out any remaining aliens and come on home. New objective.
Now they could be. I'm not sure if it means there's like a pod of aliens just roaming around, or if that means there's still reinforcements I gotta expunge. Either way,
aye, aye, Commander.
I'm not doing anything this turn. Actually, probably the wisest thing to do would be to use this.
Moving out.
They could be inside the building. I think they might be underneath, believe it or not. Nothing. Okay then. It could. Maybe it is just random bad guys just gotta drop in, say hi. If it is, I mean, well, I'll be all set. I know aliens love to hang in this building. They just love it.
Roger that.
I don't know what it is about this building. Maybe it's actually Victoria's Secret Warehouse or something. I don't know. No, that tells you that there's definitely a hangout.
I've got a wish.
What do you know? What'd I say? Did I not call it? Seems like they love hanging out here. But I guarantee you these are the only two. Now, let's think here. What's the best way to handle this? Two aliens here. What I'd love to do, unfortunately, this is what I can't do. Sure enough. Grenade, throw it right through the door, and I'm gonna at least try to blast that cover out of the way. Whether I hit the alien or not is ancillary. Reason why is because I'm gonna use my assault to expunge this guy. And expunge she will. With a scatter laser, this is a one-sided affair.
Executed to the numbers, Strike One. Get back here on the double.
There you go. So, like I said, I'm still a little peeved about the whole thing, but we did get a newbie. And these newbies usually are pretty good. So, newbies tend to have really high will, and usually have pretty reasonable aim. I would never really consider one ass. Skinner? Do I really want to support a meta called Skinner? No way. But we also get our first colonel. Yes. Conrad Braun has made it all the way. So, Mayhem. Confers additional damage based on weapon tech level to suppression and AoE abilities. So what this means is this. If I have better weapon, if I have better tech, like say plasma weapons or whatever, I can inflict more damage. This usually means your rock, like your rockets, would then have the ability to do like two or three more additional damage. It's okay. I mean, I don't hate it. It only has one use for me. But being able to use another rocket, now that is king. And like I said, I got a new heavy, and he is Captain Miguel Sanchez, Crater. And he's actually got pretty ass stats. I'm kind of shocked by that. But it's nice to have a second heavy on the loose, simply because I have a second heavy. So, there is that going for me, I suppose. Yay? Perhaps? And my Carapace armor is complete. That's great. Now, if I want to, I can do Skeleton Suit as well, as a result. Kind of a mobile version of a Carapace armor. But we're not going to worry about that. We're worrying about the Outsider Shard right now. Now, unfortunately, I have three allies, so guess why I can't build these things. But they will be useful because they'll actually give you 4 HP instead of 1. Pretty useful indeed.
Power generator complete.
As far as this goes, well, I'd say I just gotta wait. I gotta wait for another UFO, really, before I can really do anything. And our Outsider Shard's complete, too. And oh yes, I have one more satellite I gotta deploy.
There you are.
Tactical. Do we have an eagle over these coordinates?
Recon satellite Delta 2 is just coming into line of sight now, sir. Coming on screen.
Nothing.
No, that's impossible. I know it's there.
Switch to thermal.
Hello.
Give me subsurface.
Gotcha.
Re-establish comms with all the men.
Think of what we might find once we get inside that facility. Imagine what they might be doing down there.
I'm sure we'll find out soon enough.
Okay, we found it. Now how do we get inside?
I thought you'd never ask.
That Outsider Shard.
So
with that, we can now manufacture a skeleton key.
Machine capable of complex communication.
It doesn't cost much.
We could spend years.
Of course I can't do it because I don't have allies. Oh, boy, did I not play that one out. This is what I get for being greedy. This is what I get for being greedy and building all these laser weapons so I can get extra credits. This is exactly what I got. You know, you reap what you sow, is what they say, but yeah. So unfortunately I gotta wait for more alien stuff. More UFOs to come. Anyway, there must be some way to get into that base. Let's launch one more satellite as I can. Now, which country am I saving? This is a no-brainer for me. I'm taking the money, and I'm running with it.
Satellite uplink facilities at maximum capacity. Additional uplink required.
Now, engineers, obviously, I've got a couple of them, but I don't think I'll have enough to do another uplink, unfortunately. That's fine. Don't really worry about that. So, our next tactic... Our next topic of discussion is going to be assaulting the alien base, which is kind of like the midway point of the game. Unfortunately, I need to build a skeleton key to do that. It's really significant because it's once you get to the alien base that the panic becomes less prevalent. I'll explain more later. But for right now, let's get to the council report. Let's go from there. Now, Australia left. Because 5 panic. But it was either abandon, Australia or abandon 3 European countries. That was like a no-brainer for me. Commander, this council is pleased to see our continued support of this project has been. But I'm pretty overjoyed with what I got. We hope that your current success. 506 credits to play with. An enduring effort to eliminate the extraterrestrial threat. I still don't have enough, unfortunately, but whatever. But I am overjoyed. And now, as you see, I can turn a pretty good multi-profit at 248. So, much better than what I used to be. I've come pretty far from the 50 credits I get from Japan. Thank you very much, guys. Anyway, with so many credits, I think I'm going to go and actually start investigating other things. Laboratories might be an option. Or workshops. Workshops give me more engineers than you want. Let's do that. I never build workshops and laboratories, like I think I've said previously, but I have the luxury. I have the luxury of money right now. But let's see what's going on.
Satellite coverage now available over.
There's gonna be a terror mission or something. Africa. That's modest. Very modest. And you know what? I'm gonna say no. I'm not going to do it. I can use these things to build aim uplinks, and I think they're more vital for this. Just an opinion, but I'll leave one in the pocket just in case.
Commander, we're detecting a new contact.
This is it, right here. Than anything we've previously encountered. This is sort of your.
We scramble our best equipped fighters.
This is sort of your even money. You pull this one out. This right here is, I believe, an abductor. It's a tough one. Can we do it with a laser cannon? Yes, but it might require luck. And this is where you really want to slap on your matrices and your aims.
Nearing strike range.
Otherwise, you'll hate yourself. Come on, RG! Ah! Gotta pull off. Dang it! Even money if you can get that guy, but if you can't, well... You can't! So, unfortunate.
We have multiple reports, but
what can you do?
In progress. The locations are marked on the hologlobe.
Another support. I need another support. Like I need another hole in my head. Scientist from the UK, but the UK, Europe should be in pretty decent shape, except for Russia. India would cause them to go crazy, and right now the other half of the world's looking pretty testy. And no engineers. So, here's the thing. I really, really, really wanted to get that abductor down. It would have been a difficult mission for sure. But, it would give me the alloys I needed to really go move forward. If I had that, I could be able to go right after the base. Unfortunately, we failed. Happens. That's a letter to grade the merit, by the way. Unfortunately. There will be scouts and stuff later on, but... Probably as a landing, if I had to guess. It's just a little upsetting. It would have been a very difficult mission, though. I will say that much, because I think there'd be like, you know, like a dozen and a half aliens just saying hi. And they can involve some pretty nasty mothers like mutons. I've seen chrysalids in there before. That's never fun. But I digress. We have abductions coming up next time, so we'll wait till then. 40 warriors signing off.